Hey everyone, and welcome to our first in-depth look at Rogues in Shadowlands. If you've been keeping up with our tier lists, it'll be no surprise that Rogues are currently looking to be one of, if not the best class for PvP. In this video, we'll be taking a look at exactly why that is, while also covering all the basics to help you get started with your own Rogues the moment Season 1 of Shadowlands begins, including the best races, talents, covenants, soulbinds, conduits, and legendaries. We'll also be releasing a refresher guide when Season 1 starts that will cover any outdated information in this guide, along with a more advanced look at how to deal damage, perfect your playstyle, and what your best comps are. So be sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified the moment those guides are out. To kick things off, let's talk about what's changed from BFA into Shadowlands. First and foremost, subtlety has returned as the go-to spec for rogues, and we're no longer seeing every rogue rely on the strong, consistent damage that Assassination has been offering since Legion. So, why is that? Well, a few key changes to rogues have made this possible. The biggest one is the return of poisons to every rogue spec. Throughout BFA, Assassination was the only rogue spec with access to Immortal Strike effect in the form of wound poison. Beyond that, another set of changes have resulted in sub damage no longer being subpar, and in fact, it now deals significantly higher damage than the other specs. This is the result of Eviscerate being made to deal shadow damage, along with Symbols of Death being buffed to allow your next Shadow Strike to crit. Pairing these changes with a few Shadowlands additions, including the recently nerfed but still incredibly powerful legendary, Akari's Soul Fragment, leaves us with sub-rogues hitting really hard during their setups, completely making up for any lack of consistent damage. So, what does this mean for Rogue's playstyle? Well, previously when playing Assassination in BFA, most of the time rogues would be looking to deal as much consistent damage as possible while just landing kidneys on CD. This would ideally be paired with cross CC from the rogue's teammate, but wasn't always necessary due to how potent an Assassination rogue's consistent damage was. Moving into Shadowlands, that's no longer the case, and rogues are poised to see a return to the playstyle we all grew accustomed to many years ago. Rogues will once again be expected to contribute to CC by making smart use of their entire toolkit, especially as Shadow Dance means that rogues can better utilize Kidney Shot for CC or swaps on different targets. Alright, so with all of that being said, how good are rogues right now? If we had to give them a rating, honestly, they'd score a 10 out of 10. Burst, they've got it. CC, don't get us started. Defensives, have you ever tried killing a rogue? Mobility, good luck kiting one. The question that should be asked is not what rogues have, but what they don't have. Their toolkit pretty much encompasses everything you could ever want from a class in WoW PvP. The only thing that you could possibly complain about is their consistent damage, but the return of Rupture and Slice and Dice means even that isn't as bad as it once was. This certainly leads us to believe that rogues are in need of nerfs. While their toolkit isn't necessarily stronger than it was in the past, the fact that they have so much control while now being able to dish out such extreme burst means something needs to be toned down, most likely their damage. With that being said, even if rogues took a significant nerf to their burst damage, the pacing of the game right now, along with how strong their toolkit is, means that rogues will likely remain to be one of the strongest melee. By the way, if you're enjoying the video so far, a sub to the channel would be incredible. Alright, next up we're going to take a look at everything you need to get started with your own rogues, starting with the best races. If you're playing Alliance, you have two competitive options, Human and Night Elf. While Night Elf was highly regarded as the go-to race for rogues in BFA, this was mostly due to every rogue playing Assassination, and so Shadow Meld was necessary to assist your team with cross CC every time you wanted to set up a kill. Now that we're returning to subtlety though and have access to Shadow Dance, Night Elf is no longer mandatory and instead becomes more about personal preference. The gap between Human and Night Elf is a lot more blurred, and you'll definitely be able to get away with either race at the top of the ladder. It's likely that rogues playing Human will pick up a Relentless Trinket and have a better matchup into other rogues thanks to the consistent stun reduction, whereas Night Elves will stick to using a normal medallion and have a more flexible playstyle, making use of Shadow Meld for an additional setup every 2 minutes thanks to Subterfuge. Horde players, on the other hand, only still have one competitive option, Orcs. The stun reduction from Hardiness coupled with the extra damage from Blood Fury makes Orcs hands down the only viable race for rogues playing on Horde. Okay, So you've picked your race. Now let's get your talents in order. Starting with the level 15 row, premeditation is easily your best pick here. A throwback to a talent bold, the newly designed premed lets you get slice and dice up in the opener without needing to use a global and spend combo points on it. This should not be underrated, as it's an excellent quality of life pick that makes rogue gameplay a lot more fluid. Next up in the level 25 row, subterfuge is your talent of choice. Not only does it let you stun more targets every time you come out of stealth, but it also adds 1 second to your shadow dance, which is your main source of burst damage. Night Stalker could also see use in some matchups if you instead want to set up huge one-shots, but overall it doesn't provide the same flexibility that Subterfuge brings, making it a worse pick overall. Moving down to the level 30 row, Marked for Death is the go-to pick, as it allows you to frequently max out your combo points to either CC off targets with Kidney Shot or for an extra Eviscerate during a setup. Energy regeneration also isn't a problem for sub-rogues, which means Vigor loses its value when compared to Marked for Death. The level 35 row sees a choice that is often incorrectly made by newer rogues. Elusiveness is by far the best choice, often allowing you to survive kill attempts on your own if timed well, for example, just before you get stunned. Usually we see newer rogues pick up Cheat Death, thinking it's the best talent here. But the fact remains that not only can you die through Cheat Death, it does not even come close to the power of elusiveness when used well. Despite being nerfed down to 5% in PvP, Prey on the Weak is still your best talent in the level 40 row, as much like the level 30 row, energy regeneration isn't a problem for sub-rogues, which means Shot in the Dark loses most of its value. Up next, we have the super strong talent, Dark Shadow. It straight up increases your damage by 30% during Shadow Dance, which, as we already mentioned, is your main source of burst damage, making this pick a no-brainer. The final choice in the level 50 row is Made For Us, as Master of Shadows is the only viable pick for PvP, because the two other options both revolve around AoE damage. With your standard talents out of the way, let's take a look at your best PvP talents. And not a whole lot has changed since BFA, with the staple trio of Cold Blood, Shadowy Duel, and Smoke Bomb still being your optimal build. Cold Blood is an easy pick, as it lets you increase your burst damage during setups and has no counterplay. Smoke Bomb has been a key part of a rogue's toolkit for 10 years and is an extremely versatile ability that can be used both offensively to score kills and defensively to survive enemy setups. And finally, we have Shadowy Duel. Added to the game in Legion, it provides some very unique gameplay for sub-rogues, allowing them to follow up CC and attempt to finish off low health targets themselves. Okay, so you've hit max level and you've got the right set of talents. What's next? Well, if you've been around since Legion, you'll be familiar with the term Borrowed Power, which is set to continue in Shadowlands. You'll need to start by choosing the best Covenant for your class, which will give you access to two abilities among a whole other host of perks that we'll cover in this section. Currently, we're recommending the Necrolords as the best Covenant for rogues. This is mostly because of how strong Serrated Bone Spike is, which is the Necrolord's rogue ability. Not only does it deal great damage, but it's also an exceptional source of combo points, especially when attacking targets at range. Fleshcraft is just an added bonus that allows you to absorb some damage while also giving you some outplay potential to immune CC if you pick up the Soulbind ability Ultimate Form. And speaking of Soulbind abilities, after selecting your Covenant, you'll unlock Soulbinds, which are essentially skill trees you'll be progressing through as you journey through Shadowlands. We recommend using Plague Divisor Merilith as your Soulbind for competitive PvP, as you gain access to that Soulbind ability that we mentioned earlier, Ultimate Form. This allows you to immune any incoming CC while channeling your Fleshcraft, and for 4 seconds afterwards if you complete the entire channel. This gives you the opportunity to make some great plays, but again, isn't the main reason why you're picking up the Covenant. Alright, you've set up your Plague Divisor Merilith as your Soulbind, but you're not done yet. You'll also need to pick up a bunch of conduits which are split up into 3 different categories, Endurance, Potency, and Finesse. Now, depending on the Soulbind that you choose and the path that you take through the Soulbind abilities, you'll gain access to different combinations of these conduits. Our recommended path through Merilith sees you choose from 2 Potency, 1 Finesse, and 1 Endurance conduit. Out of the available Endurance conduits, Recuperator is looking to be your best one by a mile, giving you a strong, consistent heal over time effect whenever you slice and dice. The selection of Potency conduits also has some really great options, with Deeper Dagger standing out as your strongest pick. This is due to Eviscerate partially dealing shadow damage, along with Shadow Blades making your combo point generation also deal shadow damage. Perforated Veins is the only other potency conduit that seems to be decent. That leaves us with Finesse conduits. Quick Decision is looking to be your best pick as it both reduces the CD and increases the range of Shadow Step, making it much easier to do things like Shadow Step Kidney Healers that are trying to max range your step. Alright, the final thing that you'll need to do is pick up your best legendary. Luckily for sub rogues, this decision is not up for debate. Akari's Soul Fragment is looking to be the best pick for sub rogues, thanks to the huge amount of additional burst that you get during your Shadow Dance. It also makes any opener with Subterfuge much more potent, and even gives Night Elf rogues an edge in some matchups, as they'll get an additional strong setup from the subterfuges their Shadow Melds will give them. All of this is due to Shadow Strike being a sub rogue's main source of damage during kill windows. Given that fact, you might see a change to this legendary choice if the damage of Shadow Strike is significantly nerfed. Alright everyone, that concludes our first look at sub rogues in Shadowlands. You should now have everything that you need to get started in Season 1, and be sure to subscribe and check back for a follow-up video which will include updates to the information in this guide, along with a more advanced look at how to deal damage, perfect your playstyle, and what your best comps are. Thanks for watching, we'll see you next time.